So a little while back, we made an episode of Proffitt's Resurrection Land Cruisers TV where it was all tech tips, and we got so much good feedback from that and requests for more that we're going to do take two of Proffitt's Resurrection Land Cruisers TV tech tips. Stay tuned. So to start the episode off, I'm going to do a tech tip myself. This one's pretty easy. So if you are restoring your seats, you're going to have a bracket like this, a seat frame, a slider, something with moving parts on it that you need to restore. These get rusty and they don't look very good. So we used to just paint these, and we actually also had them powder coated. But because they have moving parts, and this needs to slide back and forth like that, it's really hard to get paint in this, like these nooks and crannies. You have to grab the wet paint with your hand and slide it in the paint booth and paint in there and slide it back and paint in there. And you never even get it all, and then it scratches off anyway. So what we do now is, this is actually black zinc. These were black from the factory, so we use black zinc to refinish these. And the result is a kind of cooler than factory looking finish. And because this doesn't have any mill thickness, it doesn't affect the way that the seat slides. And because it's a liquid, the whole inside of this, everything is coated. So that's your tech tip. And you can find places in just about every city who will do this zinc coating for you.
Hey, introduce the new guy.
But this guy's just a temporary guy. He's like one of those ice road truckers or the moonshiners or reality show something. What kind of reality show are you?
Deadliest Catch.
Oh, yeah. See, he even has the voice for it. This guy spends his summers. I don't know, when do you go up there?
Summer,
he spends his summers skinny dipping in the Arctic Ocean, right?
Yep, way up north.
What do you do up there?
Commercial fishing.
This is Ian Bowen, and he is working for us. We're lucky enough to have him because he's a great guy and he knows what he's doing, but he's only gonna be here for the winter because in the summer he goes up there and he catches the tuna or the salmon. So, don't get too used to this pretty face on camera around here, but maybe he'll be here like seasonally. Alaska in the summer, Resurrection Land Cruisers in the winter. I like it. Yeah. What are you doing?
Fixing the tunnel cover.
So this is an early FJ40 cover. It's got no holes in it. That means this was in a cruiser that had three on the tree and vacuum transfer case, so it didn't have, Toyota marketed this, the 40, early on as something that you could put three people in the front seat, so it was important to them to not have any shifters coming up through there. So, get this baby fixed and then off to sandblast it goes.
We're talking about doing a knuckle job. Everybody that's done a knuckle job knows what this looks like and what a pain in the butt it is to hold everything up here at the same time. So what I've done is I've taken two M10 by 125 pitch bolts and cut slots in them to them and made little studs out of them. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna screw it in right here, finger tight, right here, finger tight. So your first gasket, as you can see, has an odd shape to it. It has flat sides, one rounded side. So you look for your flat side here. So we're gonna put that on there. So now we're gonna put this stub axle in. Same way, flat spot, grooved down so the water can run out of it. Next gasket, you can see the V in it. It's gonna match up to this here. So if any moisture gets in it, it runs out by itself. Now the backing plate. Boom. And the wiper. Then your bolts. And just for the purpose of demonstration, these aren't the correct bolts. These are just so we can show you how to do it. Take your gun, tap it down. Unscrew your pins. Boom. voila, complete knuckle done. No third hand in the chest. Put the rest of the bolts in it. Good to go.
So for glass, not plastic, you can use quadruple lot steel wool. For cleaning hard water stains, it works really good. People get worried about putting steel wool on glass.
It's steel. You're not supposed to rub anything with steel.
But if you get the finest one they make, you can even buy it at Walmart. It works really good for cleaning glass and chrome.
0000 steel wool.
Yes.
So I know Bob uses these for windows, everything.
But don't do it if there's window tint.
Yeah.
You can do it on the window itself for cleaning bugs, that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Works really good.
Do we have any before and after?
No, I already did them both.
No.
So, you're out of luck.
Should have done the tech tip over here earlier today.
Where were you 5 minutes ago?
Yeah. The tech tips are hard because I actually already did this thing earlier when the camera guys weren't here, but I'm gonna simulate it. So, if you're doing a restoration and you're taking the body off of your FJ40, these back body mounts are hardly ever able to be taken out without breaking them off. The nuts are hard to get to. You have to sort of go in at an angle and up to them, like with a swivel socket. And that makes it difficult to get to and get a really good bite on with any kind of an air tool. And besides that, they're always rusty anyway, and usually they break off or strip or whatever. So it's not easy to get to them. And if you're gonna throw the body mounts away anyway, there's a really easy way to get these last four body mounts. And what it is a 4.5-inch angle grinder. And I actually prefer a cordless one because they spin a lot slower, but I don't have the cordless one with me. But a 4.5-inch angle grinder with a 5-inch cutoff disc, and then you've got to get the 5-inch ones, you'll be able to reach in between the frame, which would normally be right here, and the rear sill and slice the body mounts. Now you have to cut all the way through the rubber, and it stinks. Here's one that you have to cut all the way through the rubber, right from back here and into the bolt, which you can see I've cut in half right there. But it makes them really easy to get out. You slice the bolt off close enough where you can just sort of spread this and pull it off. Obviously that body mount wasn't good anyway, so when we put it back on, we're going to use a whole new set. But that's really easy. It's like 5 minutes to get those back four body mount bolts cut with a 4.5-inch angle grinder and a 5-inch cutoff wheel. Also, I want to point out one thing. This cutoff wheel has this little bump right here. And with this grinder, that if that hit the metal, well, the grinder actually hits the metal right about the same time the bump does. But with some grinders, including my cordless one, that bump is actually a hindrance to being able to get all the way in. So if you have a choice with these wheels, I get the perfectly flat ones, and that way you can get in just a little bit deeper, barely deep enough to get to these mounts, but deep enough to make that job a lot easier. So FJ40s, later FJ40s like this, didn't have a throttle cable. They had mechanical linkage. The throttle pedal came up and bent through a hole in the firewall, and when you stepped on it, it sort of moved up and down. And that translated to another bracket to change the direction of motion a different way, and then a third bracket to change the direction of motion a different way, and that's what actuated the throttle plates and the accelerator pump and the carburetor. When you're doing aftermarket fuel injection like this, you have to go to a cable.
When modifying the throttle pedal, it's take out this bend, it comes straight up, 90's over, 90's back up, grind it off right here, and the cable clips right onto it when it's back up over here.
So here's what Alex was talking about. This is just a re-bent factory throttle pedal. Took out one bend and added one bend, ground off one attachment ball, and ready to go with a low car throttle cable. What are you doing? That's already been painted.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah. I saw you paint that door the other day. Now you're sanding on it.
Sanding on it. Yeah, I gotta get her nice and shiny, buff it up, and get all the paint nibs out of it. And
when you sand stuff, doesn't that make it the opposite of shiny?
It does make it the opposite of shiny.
So, all right. So tell the guys what you're doing.
All right. So to get a door that looks like this, the one that looks like that, we're gonna take 2,000 grit, or anywhere really. You could go all the way down to 1,000 grit if you wanted. You go around, and we go around, and we look at all the flat panels here and look for dirt nibs and stuff. I've already sanded them all out. All the imperfections in the clear coat and whatever not that are there.
So you've gone through and you've sanded out all the dirt nibs. with your DA, but you could do that with
hand sanding,
with hand sanding too.
Anything really.
Yeah, and then you're not trying to cut the orange peel out. You're just
No, not on this one. Yeah, just denibbing it. Most of this is what you see is 3,000 grit, so you keep that nice flow of the clear coat in it, so you're not cutting it completely flat.
And then, tell us about the buffer you're using to bring this back shiny again.
But this is a buffer that I'm using on this bad boy. It's a dual action, long throw. It's really safe for edges, I would say. Really safe for edges. The other one I use is this big boy right here, and that's just a regular high-speed buffer. And that one, you have to be a lot more careful around edges because you'll burn the clear coat on that, which is pretty much...
Because that pad's not as thick, right?
Well, So this one is more like a DA where it has like a dual action where it moves around like this. That one is just a straight up spin. Like it doesn't dual action. So if you leave it too long on like an edge, you can burn your clear coat. And pretty much what that does is you just take it all right off. It goes all the way down to paint. Sealer can go all the way down the middle.
And you're respraying the whole door again.
Yeah, that or very meticulous fixes.
So what kind of pad is that on this DA buffer?
This one is the final polish pad. It's the black compound. It would be the number two compound that you would get from a store or whatever.
So that's the last thing you do. What do you do before that?
You do the one compound. I like to take a wool pad first over everything, and then I take a white foam pad. Looks pretty much exactly like that. And then I go over, do foam, white pad, then a black pad, or in this case, blue pad. And
it's
then
a process.
It's done. Yep.
But if you're gonna do this process at your house, or just try to buff some scratches out, some Colorado pinstripes out, what would you use? What would you do? The polisher?
Yeah, I would just use a polisher. I'll grab probably a high speed one would be your best bet for getting it quick.
One that just spins.
Yeah, one that just spins. If you're looking for, if you don't mind spending the money, I would go for definitely the dual action long throw buffers. A foam pad or a wool pad or a foam pad, depending on how aggressive the scratches are. A nice number one compound, I don't have it back here on me right now, but you can get varying grades of that too.
The number one first and then a polish.
And then a polish, yep. So most compounds will label it one or two. So you like a one is what you start with, and obviously a two is what comes out.
Oh, they're in numerical order.
So it's even easier.
That makes so much sense to me now.
It's way easier. Yeah, so I don't know, some companies say that they can do, they have one compound for everything, for cutting and polishing. I don't believe that. So I like to have
snake
two different
oil
compounds.
Salesman.
Exactly right, those snake guys. Oils.
So when you're done with all this, this is what we're going for, right? So this is
nice and shiny, something.
100 series rear door, stage two restoration. And I bet you Todd can get down there and show that.
Yeah,
if this was a show car, like a 10,000 hour kind of show car, then we would be cutting all of this orange peel out of there, cutting the door perfectly flat so that you can't see any of that.
And then probably even re-clearing it again and then buffing it back down.
Or three times or four times.
Yeah, exactly.
That's why those really nice show cars cost $1 million, right?
Yeah.
So OEMs, this is like an OEM kind of clear. It's the same look that this car had on it when it was brand new.
So I forgot one more thing. Back to burning edges. If you want to avoid that, you're starting this for your first time at home, so you're buffing, the actual spin motion of the buffer always turns clockwise. So if you're coming up to an edge, you always want to make sure the pad is cutting off the edge. So if you cut onto the edge, that's what's going to burn the edge real bad. So if you cut off the edge, it's going to be just like that, cutting off of it. And you can pretty much ride an edge like that on a 600 RPMs.
So it's just like grinding. If you're good at grinding, you know that you're gonna run that wheel right clockwise off the edge to make the edge smoother.
Yep.
We have to change the name of this episode to Eric's Buffing Tips.
Yeah, Eric's Buffing Tips.
And we better go find some other thing we can teach.
Yeah, exactly right.
Good job, man.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm gonna show you how to open a window using shoestring and how to do it the proper way to get the window into place. So what you do is you wrap the string around each side of the windshield in the run, and then you start at the middle and work your way across and get the windshield into the run.
You know, we love these cars. In fact, we love all vehicles. And so every once in a while, we see something that just shouldn't have been done. And that's why we like to say, stop it.
Stop it.
Stop it.
Who's this? What are you doing?
Blue paint on silver parts, trying to get it all off.
Blue paint on a silver part? Who on earth would possibly do that?
Car keys, Land Cruiser owner.
Hacks. I don't think the owner did it. So these are supposed to be silver. All those parts on the inside of later two-piece doors are supposed to be silver. Toyota did paint some of these body color in the early 60s, but this is a 1974, and these should have been silver. And stop painting things that should have been silver body color. And stop painting things that were bolted together. Even these fasteners were blue, weren't they?
Oh, yeah.
Stop painting fasteners blue. Or any color.
Stop it! Stop it!
Hi, I'm Matt, and my tech tip is about corrosion prevention. And this is basically concerning rust on Land Cruisers. I'm sure you're all familiar with that. It often occurs in an area where there's two pieces of metal sandwiched together. So what we do with these is they come in, they have the sandwich rust, what we call rust between the two pieces of metal. We'll drill out the spot welds, remove this inner brace. Oftentimes we'll have to go ahead and put in a repair piece of sheet metal, as has been done on this bib. And this hull has been replaced and welded in. We also send that inner brace on the back side in for sandblasting, remove all the corrosion from it, put it back in, plug weld it, and then we also run the metal through a two-part metal etch treatment, which is a corrosion preventative. Once that's done, we are also going to go one step further with this, and we're going to seam seal completely around this inner brace. And what that does is going to keep road grime, dirt, dust, water from getting in there and sitting in there and causing the corrosion to start growing again inside of that. So we're eliminating that possibility and hopefully creating a good longevity for this body part.
So while I've got your attention, I want to tell you about some exciting changes that we've added to our website. There are three new features, and let's check them out. So the first thing we've added on the menu bar is a store. In the store, we have our PRLC parts corner. We have a lot of used parts here, and a lot of them just need new homes. We can't possibly use everything we have, and there's enough Land Cruisers and people out there trying to build their own vehicles that it just seems responsible for us to make some of what we have available to the Land Cruiser community. You'll see there's 8 different categories for parts, so get on there and browse around and see if there's something that you'd like. The second thing in the store category is our merchandise section. We've had a lot of requests for our t-shirts and swag, and so you can now get online and buy t-shirts and hats, and we're also going to be adding to that section of the website as often as we can. And the last feature on the website is something I'm very excited to finally introduce. We've been toying with the idea of helping people sell their Land Cruisers for a long time, and now it is finally here. You can consign your Land Cruiser with us, and we're also going to do our best to offer a few affordably priced Land Cruisers for sale for people who want to build their own. If you like this episode, please subscribe. Also, check us out on Instagram. We are at ProCruiser, Proffitt's Resurrection Land Cruisers on Facebook, and ResurrectionLandCruisers.com on the World Wide Web. Thanks for watching.
You guys get that?
Sorry. What's up? I didn't realize you were shooting.
We were just getting ready to.
I don't know.
We don't put him on camera yet. This is the part where he thinks about what he's going to say on camera when we are officially on camera. Actually, you should always be rolling because Bob, the funniest things Bob says are always off camera.
Am I on camera?
No.
It just looks like it.
Yeah. Todd's just practicing holding his arms up.
For hard water stains on glass.
Yeah.
I'm going to do this on plastic.
Are you rolling?
quadruple out.
Start over. Wolf.
Dude, you're killing me.
We needed a blooper.
It's so natural. I mean, it was just like flowing and you just <you know. laughs>
Okay, ready? And what are you doing, Bob?
See,
ready?
Now I'm nervous. Now you're ruining it.
But we got a good blooper.